so next we'll write down the torque equation. Should we derive it?
Yeah.
Or directly we'll write it?
Derive.
Derivation we can take later. See, what will happen is that you'll get mathematically so much bombarded with all the equations and everything that you'll not be able to enjoy the numerical stuff. Okay? First, let us do everything. You'll feel good about yourself, and then I'll tell you how that torque equation comes. Getting it? Makes sense? Right? So, torque is equal to I times alpha. Just like force is equal to mass times acceleration, torque is equal to I times angular acceleration. What is I?
Moment of inertia.
Torque we anyway know how to find out, and alpha is angular acceleration. Okay? Can I use this equation about any axis, about any point? No, I cannot use it at any axis. There's a restriction. The restriction is, please write down, this can be used only about fixed axis or any axis that passes through center of mass. This cannot be used about any other axis. If the object is rotating, if the object is not rotating, it is stationary, then every point is a fixed axis in a way. Okay? Fine? So when I'm using it about the fixed axis, I have to find torque about the fixed axis, and I have to find moment of inertia about the fixed axis. I'll get alpha about the fixed axis, isn't it? Alpha of the rigid body is fixed. Okay, alpha of every point is fixed, about every other point, any other fixed point, it is alpha only, right? Torque and I can change, but the ratio between torque and I will remain same only. Okay? Getting it? Okay. Ready? Again, solve problem now. Torque to I alpha, or whatever, what else? There's no other theory. Okay? Torque is equal to I alpha. Okay? And then if suppose there is an external force applied on a rigid body, of course there will be external force because there is a torque, right? Most probably there will be an external force. So net external force along x-axis will be mass into acceleration along x-axis. This acceleration is whose acceleration?
Center
of mass is acceleration. So now you have alpha as well as A, ACM. And using the kinematics, you can find out the total acceleration now. First you observe with respect to center of mass, then you add what center of mass is doing. Okay? Similarly, Fy will be equal to M into Ay, Fz is equal to M into Az. Okay? Do not hesitate to use all these equations you already have learned. Newton's second law is still valid. Net force equal to mass and acceleration. But whose acceleration? Center of mass is acceleration. That you should apply without hesitating. Apart from that, there is a torque equation also which will give you alpha. Alright, and if suppose you have a relation between alpha and A, if you know that it is rolling without slipping, alpha is equal to A by R or A is equal to alpha R, then you can connect the this equation with that equation, because alpha is equal to A by R, so you can, there is a connection between these two equations. Are you getting it? But if suppose there is no relation between alpha and A, there is no connection. Are you getting it? Is it clear? Okay. So let's take a couple of simple questions, then you will understand how you can apply this. There is a rod of mass M and length L. Okay. Rod of mass M and length L can rotate about this fixed axis. Okay, let's say it rotates by an angle of theta. harassment mein. Okay, you need to find out the angular acceleration at this moment.
So it is 12 cos theta by log. So 3g cos theta by log. So 3g cos theta by log.
3g cos theta by
log. 3g cos theta by
log. Wrong.
Yeah, it's by 2l.
So 3g
cos theta by log. 2l.
Yeah.
Check.
By
2l.
Because gravity is low by 2l.
Oh.
Yeah,
it acts. See, mg will act from the center. Mg, right? There will be forces. Forces honge na bhai? Theek hai. Let's take forces like this. There will be one force this way and another force like that. Let us say. This you can say ny, and this you can say nx. I mean, I don't know which direction the reaction from the pin is exerting. So I'll just say that it will be in a single plane only. Otherwise, the rod will come out. It will remain in a single plane. So the reaction force from the pin will be on that plane only. So assume it has two components, one in X and one in Y component. Are you getting it? Right? So now I have to find out the angular acceleration. Is there a fixed axis? First step is to find out if there is a fixed axis. Yes. A fixed axis? Alright, listen here. This is mg. This is a fixed axis or not? About this it rotates. This component of mg is what? Why I am finding that component? Because that is perpendicular to the distance. How much is that?
Mg
cos theta.
Yeah.
Okay. So this is mg cos theta. This is 90 degrees theta, you guys are saying. So this is mg sine theta. So torque because of mg is what? Is there any other force which can give torque about the fixed axis? No. Only mg can give. So torque because of mg is mg cos theta into
L by 2.
This is equal to moment of inertia about fixed axis into alpha, which is what? ML square by 3 into alpha. So, kitna hai alpha?
3g
by 2l cos theta. Okay, now you have to find out what will be its angular velocity when it has reached a vertical position like that. Angular velocity. Omega is what? Omega when the rod has become vertical. Ha bhai?
Sir, 3g cos theta.
3g cos theta. Y minus theta.
Okay. From where are you getting theta? I am releasing from here, theta is 0. And here I am finding the angular velocity. So theta is 90. From 0, theta is 90. What is omega?
Sir,
and what is theta?
Is it
3g by 2?
Pi by
2. Theta is pi by 2. So theta pi by 2 kaun dalega us expression?
Sir, it's pi by 2.
So what is the answer?
Under root 3g cos
root 3
theta
pi by 2.
Root 3g pi by 2. Basically it's root, under root pi alpha.
Not correct.
Wait, so like from this position till the vertically?
It is released from here, aisa hai, ye rod aisa hai, aisa gaya to uska angular velocity kya hai?
Oh.
Aise to KVPY mein thode bata ke batayega, ye kuch nahi samjha raha hai, chalo batao kaise ho. Ye sector bhi kam dekho, aisa rod hai, ye kitna angular velocity
hai. So because you drew that, so I thought you meant from that angle to the vertical.
Oh, like that.
That's what I, yeah.
Oh.
Adu? Okay.
My mistake.
Root of 3g by 2.
Sounds correct.
What do you say?
Not sure. 3g by 2. How did you get it?
I took omega alpha is omega into d omega by
2. Bas wahi karna hai. Here you need to apply kinematics. This is alpha. Alpha is what? Omega d omega by d theta. Then you write A is equal to V dV by dx. Same thing here. and then integrate. Omega d omega 3g by 2l cos theta d theta integral. Omega goes from 0 to omega, theta goes from 0 to pi by 2. Okay? Like this, you will get the answer.
Sir, why can't we conserve energy?
Because I haven't taught yet.
No, so like can I just say that it starts off with potential energy, mg?
No, not now. Mm-hmm. I don't want you to use conservation of energy right now. Alright, I'll teach, then you can use.
So, but then the answer with that is?
No, you have done it wrong. I'll check that during the breaks, okay? Are you getting it?
So, but the sign is minus 10.
What minus?
So, cos 0 minus cos pi by 2 minus cos 0.
And this is a square.
So, it's minus pi by 2, sir. It's going this way.
So theta, which is 0 to 90, is me get out
of here.
So it's
coming
as
0.
Sine.
Integral of cos theta is what?
Sine.
Integral of cos theta is what?
Sine theta.
It is sine theta. It is not minus sine theta. Okay? It is sine is minus cos. It is reverse. Alright? Any other doubt?
So I'm not, but I'm just.
Full.
So I thought that if the center of mass moves from that top position to that position over there.
Top.
Right. So no, sir. The bottom. So the change in height of center of mass is L by 2.
L by 2. Mg L by 2 is loss in potential G, which is
so
equal to half I omega square. I is ml square by 3.
Half I omega square. Because not half mv square.
No, why half mv square? It is rotating, it's not translating.
So you can see that velocity of center of mass is some v.
Then you can write half ICM omega square plus half mvcm square. And vcm is omega into L by 2. That's what I'm saying. Wait for me to teach. If it, otherwise, you will not learn what I am going to teach and you will not learn what I am teaching right now.
Yes.
Both you will not learn. Arey, mita diya yaar. Shit. Then you have to find the reaction from the pin. Find out when it was making an angle theta like this. Ye param ki vajah se. This is angle theta. You need to find out these two reactions. Let's say this is Ry and this is Rx.
So will Rx be 3d sin theta by 2?
What is the logic that you will use?
Like, you will have a force, when it's rotating, one force will act inward and outward and they should be equal.
Logic?
So you can take centripetal acceleration.
Centripetal acceleration will be along the rod. So Rx will be equal to mv square by L by 2, the radius with which the center of mass is moving. Are you getting it? So Rx is equal to mass into vcm square divided by L by 2. Yeah, is one man? Okay. What about Ry? It has angular acceleration. So center of mass has what acceleration? Alpha into?
L by 2.
But Ry we have taken in opposite direction. So let's keep it this way. This is Ry. So Ry is equal to M into acceleration of center of mass, which is alpha into?
L by 2.
Finding alpha is straight. Alpha is 3g by 2l cos theta. So substitute here, you get Ry. For Rx, you need VCM, and VCM is omega into L by 2. Okay, so this will come out to be M omega square L by 2. Omega you get from here by integrating 0 to theta. Okay, total reaction will be what? Root over this square plus that square.
So we'll have some centripetal.
Got it? Question? Out.
I don't know why you can't just
what?
Conserve energy. I think
no, you can conserve energy, huh? That is what I said. I am saying you are using it in the wrong way. And I can't teach everybody spending everybody's 15 minutes how to conserve energy and then tell you. Are you getting it? You are using the wrong formula for kinetic energy. Either you write half ICM omega square plus half MVCM square, or you write half I about fixed axis into omega square. You're using neither. You're saying just kinetic energy is half MVCM square, which is not correct.
So that's not the correct kinetic
energy. That's not the correct kinetic energy. Okay. When you write half MVCM square, you're assuming that entire mass is translating without rotating with VCM.
Okay.